my session, okay? And let me share my screen. Sorry. Yeah. Everyone can see my screen, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, great. And okay, that's fine. Right, let's just quickly ask some of the questions from the previous session. Yeah, what is a database? What is meant by SQL Server?
Storing and retrieving the data.
Okay, SQL Server is a what kind of software?
RDBMS software.
Very good, RDBMS software to use, you're going to use to
store the data, process the data, to retrieve the data, and backend application.
Very good, exactly, right, fine. And who is the father of RDBMS?
EF Cod.
EF Cod, okay, good, okay. Fine. What are the versions of the SQL Server? What are the versions of the SQL Server? How many versions are there?
Starting from 97.
Okay.
97, 2000, 2005, 2012, 2008, R2, 2017, 2015, 2019.
14, 2016, 17, 19.
Very good. Okay. What are the Windows versions?
Windows NT 3.0.
Windows NT
3.0,
4.0. 2000, 2008, 2009, 2012, R2, 2016.
And platform. What is the latest version of Windows Server?
19.
Windows plus Linux, sir, after 2017. Windows plus Linux.
Windows plus Linux, that is different thing, okay? So what is the latest version of Windows Server?
Windows Server 2019.
Okay, very good. Windows Server 2019. Okay, so I'll ask you one question, just only one. Try to answer the question, okay? Don't answer at a time. Right, so I want to install SQL Server 2012, okay? Can anyone tell me what are the Windows Server versions that are going to, okay, allow to install SQL Server 2012? Windows Server versions. I need all the Windows Server versions which support SQL Server 2012. I need only one. Okay. Just answer.
Plus seven.
Sorry.
+7 or -7?
+7, -7. Yeah, just calculate and let me know the answer. Okay.
Windows Server.
Okay. 2012 minus 7 is 2005 to 2019. Okay. Yeah. Now tell me, what and all Windows Servers are there in this range?
2003. Windows okay. Server 2003.
How come Windows Server 2003?
Windows Server 2008.
Okay. Windows Server 2003 means it's less than 2005, right? Which won't allow to install, okay? Windows 2008. Okay.
Then 2008 or 2012.
Okay.
2012 or
2. Okay.
2012 or 2.
Okay. Okay. After that, what Windows Server versions we have?
16.
Okay. Vishnuvardhan, let me check whether you joined from laptop or phone. Vishnuvardhan, okay. Just 1 minute, please. Yeah, you can record the session, Vishnu.
Okay.
Yeah. Guru Prasad, in case if you're having voice issues and all, just reconnect. Okay. Everyone can hear me, right? Clearly. Any issues from my end? Please confirm. Is it clear? My voice is clear? Okay. Okay, Guru, in case you are facing any issue, Guru Prasad, okay, just reconnect again. Sometimes it is going to fix the issue, okay? Yeah.
No problem. No.
Yeah, okay. That's fine, and Windows Server 2016. Okay, that's fine. What are the three-tier architecture in the application? What servers will be there in the three-tier architecture?
Web server. Application server, web server.
Okay.
And database server.
Okay.
Application server also, sir.
So first is web server, then application server, then your database server. Okay. Okay. Very good. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for your answers, responses, and all. Let me start the session. Okay. So these are the. Come on. Right. Let me ask you this one. This question, which is very important. What is the build number for SQL Server 2014?
2017.
2012.
What is the build number for SQL Server 2014?
2017 SQL Server.
Come on. What is the build number? Build number.
15.0. 15.0.
12.0.
No, 15.0.
Okay. Tell me, is it 12.0 or 15.0?
12.0.
Okay, the build number which will start for SQL Server 2014 is 12.0. What is the build number for SQL Server 2000?
8.0.
Very good. Okay. Build number for SQL Server
2012?
11.0. Very good. Good. Okay. Fine. And what is the build number for SQL Server 2019?
15.0.
Okay, very good. What is the build number for SQL Server 2013?
2016, sir.
There is no
2013. 13th build number, sir. 2016.
13th is not. Okay, don't confuse. Build number is different. Version is different. There is no SQL Server 2013, okay?
2013.
No. Good. Fine. Let me start the discussion. So in the last class, we have discussed about the versions, okay? Different versions of SQL Server, different versions of, Guru Prasad, what happened? Any issues? Can you hear me? Guru Prasad, can you hear me?
Yeah. Tell me, sir. No problem.
So you sent a message, right, sir? Please respond something like that. Right. Not Guru. Guru Prasad.
Okay.
Okay. You're Guru Praveen, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's fine. Right. Okay. So in the last class, we have discussed the versions of the SQL Server. We have SQL Server 2000 onwards, okay, which is like coming to the market. SQL Server 2000 came into the market in the year of 2000. After that, we have 2005, 8, 8, R2, 12, 14, 16, 17, and 19, okay? And we have Windows Server versions as well, okay? Windows Server 2000, 2003, 2008, 8R2, and 2012, 12R2, and 16, 19 also we have. And we have already discussed what is platform dependent and what is platform independent. Can anyone tell me up to which version SQL Server is a platform dependent?
2016, sir.
Yes, up to SQL Server 2016, SQL Server is a platform dependent. That means you can either install SQL Server on either desktop operating systems or Windows Server operating systems. Only on Windows operating systems you can install SQL Server up to SQL Server 2016. From SQL Server 2017 onwards, you can install on Linux machines as well as Windows operating systems also, Windows desktops and Windows Server operating systems, okay? And how many parts the build number contains?
Four parts,
okay? Major version, minor version, actual build number, and revision history. What is the query to check the version of the SQL Server?
At version, sir.
Select at version, okay? Select at version will help you, okay, to find out the version of the SQL Server. Very good, okay? So, let me discuss this CTP, RC, RTM, then we'll go for the Okay, editions of the SQL Server, components of the SQL Server, then we'll try to build one virtual machine today. Okay, right? Fine. So CTP, RC, RTM, what is this terminologies? Where we are going to use these terminologies? Okay, how come those are useful for us? In case if you don't have questions, please mute from your side so that no noise will be there in the recordings. Okay, right? If you have questions, unmute and let me know. Fine. So, okay, so recently we are all experiencing the COVID issues, right? So we have a vaccine for that. Once vaccine came into the market, okay, government of India didn't distribute the vaccine for all at a time. Please mute it, otherwise I'll mute all. Okay. Okay. In case you have any questions, just unmute. Okay, unmute and let me know. Right. So for any project, there will be a test drive. Okay, we can call it as a pilot project. Pilot project means what? A test project kind of thing. Earlier, once the vaccination is introduced, okay, government of India didn't give vaccine for all the people. Just for pilot project, the government of India choose some of the locations in the country, some of the people in the country, it just started giving vaccination, right? So for any project, whether it is a healthcare project or RLC, any project, any product, will have a test phase. Okay, so CTP, say for example, we have SQL Server 2019 versions are there. Later in the year of 2023, maybe SQL Server wants, Microsoft wants to release a new version of the SQL Server. Okay, maybe in the year of 2023 or 2024, Microsoft wants to release a new SQL Server version. So if it wants to release, it won't start preparing the packages and all in the year of 2023, right? It will start building the packages from 2021, 2022, they will have target. So once the new version of SQL Server is ready, it won't directly release the software into market. Okay, first it will release the software to the community people. Community people means everyone can join in the Microsoft community. You can also join as a community member. Okay, so once you join to the community, whatever Microsoft products are there, you can experience, okay, before the products come into the market. The community people can experience the products, can work with the products before the products are going to come into the market. Okay, so it's kind of a test project. So Microsoft will release the particular version in the community people, so that community people will get a separate link. They can download the version. They can install the SQL Server in their laptop. They can work with it. In case of any issues, they can complain to Microsoft or they can report to Microsoft, so that Microsoft is going to rectify the issues and all. See, Microsoft also, even though Microsoft is releasing a product, a new product, don't think no bugs and all will be there. Lot of bugs will be there. Microsoft means they are also people, right? They can also do mistakes. So lot of bugs will be there. Okay. So what happened is, once they just released the particular product into the market, then they came to know from the reviews of the users, then they came to know what are the bugs, what are working fine, what are not working properly. Everything, they will prepare a report. Based on the report, they are going to rectify all the issues. So CTP means Community Technology Preview. It is also one software. Okay, it is also one software. So the SQL Server software only. CTP is a SQL Server software which will be released for community people just for testing purpose and all, to find out the bugs, errors. Okay, in case anything is not working properly, which is good, which is not bad, which has to be improved. So it is going to welcome the suggestions from the customers. Okay, so that is called Community Technology Preview. Community Technology Preview is a pre-release. So we have movies, right? Movies, we have pre-release, right? So what we can say, benefit booking show, something like that. Okay, earlier, before the morning show, we'll have one more show, pre-release, something like that. Okay. So in the same way, in case Microsoft wants to release a new service, a new software into the market before to the product, it is going to release the pre-release of the particular software. That is called, that version is called CTP version, Community Technology Preview. Okay, this version you can download it, you can install it, you can work with it. It's a just a pilot project kind of thing. But you cannot install this CTP in the production environment and all. Why? Because it's free. I told you, right? Free softwares you cannot install in the production environment. Okay, just you can only test the features and all. What and all new features are there in the 2023, SQL 2023. Like that, just to check the new features and to check any bugs are there. Just to find out these bugs and all, Microsoft will pre-release the software that is called CTP, okay, Community Technology Preview. Once CTP is completed, then it will collect all the information from the users. It will check what has to be improved, what are the bugs and all. Then it will fix all the bugs. Microsoft will fix all the bugs. Then again, it will go for the second test copy that is called RC. We can call them as Release Candidate. Okay. Release Candidate. Release Candidate means that is also one SQL Server software copy. Okay. Release Candidate means that is also one SQL Server software copy. Okay. Once they fix all the bugs in the CTP version, then they are going to release one more test copy called RC. That also you can download from the internet. You can work with it. Okay. And in case of any bugs, you can intimate to the Microsoft, or you can inform to the Microsoft so that they are going to fix the issues in the RC. Finally, they will release the RTM version of the SQL Server 2023. SQL Server 2023 is just an example. Okay. In case if they want to release any new server, any new SQL Server software, this is the process. Okay. For every SQL Server new version, first they will release the CTP version of that particular SQL Server 2023. Once they fix all the bugs, again they will release the RC version of SQL Server 2023. Once all the bugs are fixed in the RC also, then finally they will come into the market. Okay. That version is called RTM version, okay, release to market. So whenever you are installing a SQL Server, sometimes in the organization they will ask you, please install SQL 2019 RTM. RTM means what? RTM means the base copy of a SQL Server. RTM means the base copy of the first copy of the SQL Server is called an RTM. Okay, this is a paid version. Okay, you have to pay for that. Okay, you have to pay the amount and all. You have to buy the product and then only you can install the software. Okay, RTM means release to market. Every software will have an RTM version. SQL Server 2016 will have 2016 RTM, 2019 RTM, 2012 RTM, 2014 RTM, means the base, the first copy of the software is called an RTM. On top of the RTM, we are going to install the updates. Okay, on top of the RTM, we are going to install the updates. Those updates are called service packs. On top of the RTM, we are going to install the updates. Those updates are called service packs. We have a separate session on patching. What is meant by service pack? What is meant by cumulative update? What is meant by hot fixes? How to patch a SQL Server? Very important activity we are going to do regularly in the organization. Okay, we'll discuss all the process for patching and all. So the base software copy is an RTM software. On top of that, in case if we want to install any updates, those updates we can call it as a service packs. Okay, this is the difference between a CTP, RC, RTM. Is it clear or any issues?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, right. Bill number, we have discussed. Bill number contains four parts: major version, minor version, actual bill number, and revision history. Okay, right. And editions. Let's discuss the editions. Okay, so what and all editions are there in the SQL Server? We have different type of editions in SQL Server. First, let's discuss what is meant by edition. Okay, let's discuss what is meant by edition. So let's go with the same common example for every batch, which you can easily understand. Okay, in case if you are a member of any matrimony site, if you are a member of any matrimony site, daily they are going to send some emails, profiles. If you are a male, they are going to send some female profiles. If you are a female, they are going to send some male profiles. Okay, daily you are going to get an email. Okay, these are the available matches for you, like that. Okay, if you there, you can see one more option called upgrade now. Okay, upgrade, or else let me open any matrimony site so that you can easily understand. Okay. What is that famous matrimony? Okay. Okay. Somewhere you can see upgrade option. Okay, that's fine. I think I have to, okay, log in. I have to register for that, but okay, let me close it. Okay, fine. So if you go to the matrimony site and all, just an example, okay, if you go to the matrimony site and all, there you can see, okay, different products, okay, silver plan, okay, gold plan, platinum plan. So what is the difference between these plans, silver plan, gold plan, platinum plan? Silver plan, usually they are going to, example, okay, they will provide some 10 matches per month. Okay, they are going to send some 10 profiles per month, and they will tell you the phone number and all. Okay, only basic details you are going to get if you purchase the silver plan. Means all the details are there with them. Matrimony company will maintain all the data. But what they will do if you choose a silver plan, they are going to open some of the features for you. They are not going to give you unlimited features and all for you. Okay, maybe 10 profiles per month. Okay, 10 mobile numbers. You can directly contact them like that. Okay, if you go to gold plan, 20 profiles per month. Okay, 20 contacts, horoscope list and all, so that you are going to get extra features in the gold plan. If you go to platinum plan, maybe 100 profiles per month, all the horoscopes, all the contacts. Okay, so the features are going to be unlocked in every plan. Silver plan, some of the features are locked, which will be unlocked in the gold plan. In the gold plan, some of the features are locked, which will be unlocked in the platinum plan. How we have different plans in the matrimony, in the same way, okay, we have additions in the SQL Server. Additions means limitations to the features. Addition means limitations to the feature is called an addition in the SQL Server. Okay, means features will be there, but those features won't work. Okay, we have different features in we have different additions in SQL Server. Some of the additions are Express edition, which is a free edition. If I just register for free in the matrimony site, what I'll get? Nothing. Simply I'll get the profiles, matching profiles. That's it. Simply I'm going to get the matching profiles. I'm not going to get even details also. Okay, I'm not going to get the details also if I just go for a free account. Why? Because they want to sell their data. How come they are going to provide the data for free? Right? So in the same way, we have different editions in the SQL Server. Famous editions are Express edition, okay, Evaluation edition. Famous editions are Express edition, which is the free edition. Okay, the problem with the Express edition is lot of limitations are there. The database size not more than 10 GB. It won't allow to create a database more than 10 GB. Why? Because it's a free edition, right? And there is no SQL Server agent in the Express edition. Okay, so what happened if there is no SQL Server agent service? You cannot schedule the jobs, you cannot create the jobs. Okay, so lot of features are locked in the Express edition, but it's free. What is the use? We cannot use any feature, right? So like that express edition will be useful. And evaluation edition is free for 180 days, which is 6 months. Again, lot of features are locked in the evaluation editions. Then we have standard edition, okay, and developer edition, and we have enterprise edition also. From SQL Server 2017 onwards, the developer edition is also free. From SQL Server 2017 onwards, right? We have a lot of versions, right? 2000, 2005, 2003, 5, 8, 8, 12, okay, 14, 16, 17, 19, okay, up to SQL Server 2017, okay, you have to pay for the developer edition. But from SQL Server 2017 onwards, okay, the developer edition is free. All features are there in the developer edition, but the limitation is you cannot install developer edition in the production environment. We have already discussed earlier. In the organization, you will have different types of environments. Remember, each point which I am discussing is an interview question. Sometimes, even though you keep 5 years also, just 1 minute, please. The meeting is going to close now automatically for every 40 minutes. Same link will be there. Please connect with the same link. Okay. Again, the meeting will close now automatically. Just try to connect with the same link immediately. Okay. Save the link on the desktop and try to connect with the same link immediately. It is showing less than 1 minute. It will disconnect now. Again, okay. Please try to connect immediately. Last time I see the same issue. Okay. Please don't skip it. Once the meeting closed automatically, please use the same link to connect. Okay.